Thank you. inside of me. Psalm says, may you delight in the inside, in the inside of me. This morning's theme is worship unrestrained.
There we go.
Can you repeat that after me? Worship unrestrained. The best way to unrestrain your worship is to think about all of the things that God has done. Because worship is a response. Let's do that again. Let's do that again. As a teacher, we operate out of what's called a backwards design model.
Yes, sir.
Meaning that when we do that, we begin with the end in mind.
Yes, sir.
Right? Say it one more time. Think about this with me. We begin with the end in mind.
Yes, sir.
Now, Jesus has already paid the price.
That's right.
We say the Bible, we already paid the price.
That's right.
So today's theme is worship unrestrained.
Yeah.
Now, this is a continuation of what we did on the first Sunday of the year.
Where
you wrote your baggage on the note card.
Right.
Everybody remember that? Raise your hand if you remember that when you wrote your baggage on the note card. I remember what my baggage said. Do you remember what yours said?
Yes.
And in that, I swore to God, I made a vow to God, that when I put it on this altar, that I would leave it right here.
Right here.
So that this year's worship could be unrestrained. So we want to start this service off already giving God thanks and praise for what he's done, for who he is, for how he's brought us out, for the victory that he's already given us, for the price that he's already paid. So this time I'm going to say the thing, and I want you to give God a worship unrestrained praise. Whatever that looks like to you, whatever that means to you, I want you to give God a worship unrestrained praise. Now this Sunday we like to do things differently. This aisle is empty right now, if you feel like it is. This altar is empty right now. If you feel like it, come be alone. I want you to do whatever it takes to give God an unrestrained praise.
Inside.